We are in a high school right now.
The green room is in the middle of a high school. Indiana? Can't make this shit up.
Hey there, my name is Yale, and you might remember me from classics such as Ben's last vlog. Anyway, I'm here to give you some context. So Ben comes into work the other day with a pile of, well, hours of footage of him sitting in a car in the middle of nowhere, having a conversation with this guy. This guy, his name is Rick Barker, and he's one of those guys you've probably never heard of, but you actually have. He was Taylor Swift's manager, the one who started her career, and
Rick Barker.
He currently manages Trent Harmon.
The winner of American Idol season 15 is Trent Harmon!
He also hosts the Music Industry Blueprint podcast, and he's an expert on starting young artists' careers. Anyway, the other day, Ben was back in Nashville visiting family when he and Rick took an impromptu road trip from Nashville to Indiana to see one of Trent's shows. Along the way, they had a bunch of different conversations about how to form relationships in the industry, how to start your career, how to stay relevant on social media, and a bunch of other stuff like that. We're gonna go catch up with them somewhere in the middle of nowhere.
We're going up to see Trent Harmon. Where are we on a tour right now?
It's just a city festival.
Oh, sick.
It's just playing at this little frickin' town in Indiana. I mean, I make bonds with people in all different kinds of social settings. For me, the golf course.
Yeah.
You know, more road trips or wherever. When you really get to spend time with someone to get to know who they are outside of, you know, dancing at the club. In LA, it's different anyway because, and I say this respectfully, but in that situation, especially in Hollywood, it's a lot of fake shit.
Are those real?
Yeah, man.
You know, it's like, you're not always getting what you think you're getting or not. You know, Instagram's a perfect example of that. Snapchat's a perfect example of that.
What do you coach people to be the best strategy for Instagram stories?
It depends on what you're wanting to accomplish. It's like, if you're actually telling a story, I think it's fun. You know, I think if you're going to take people throughout your day and you can piece that day together and you have an interesting life or something like that, I think it's a lot of fun. I think for artists right now, it's a great place to play music. Share your original music. I think it's a great place to ask questions and get people to leave comments. I think the more you can use live video, because all Instagram stories is just like with the live videos. Instagram, Facebook, Twitter has said that they will let more people see live. Stories, they pop up right across the front of your feed, you know, so it's giving you a chance. So that's what I'm coaching people on, is why aren't you using every tool and doing everything you can to make yourself pop up? I'm more concerned for me is that person, that artist, showing up every day. If they're showing up every day, then I can work with them because I know they got the work ethic. If I just see that they're posting every time they have a show, or if I see that all they do is talk about themselves, but if I see that they're showing up every day and they're giving a shot at it, I can teach them what to post. I can't teach them work ethic. I can't teach them what I call give a damn.
Yeah.
With a lot of people that want to be artists, as they talk a good talk and they, man, I'm willing to do whatever it takes. No, they're not.
Yeah.
When it comes down to it, they've been taught that they will succeed just off of how good they sound. And you worked on Idol. There's no shortage of pretty people that can sing, ugly people that can sing.
Honestly, I think that's 10% of it these days.
It was worth it. Staying up late, getting up early, you know, losing your voice because you practiced your song 1,000 times. You know, this music game is such a, for lack of a better word, it's a crapshoot. And you put so much into this investment and you don't know if you're going to get a return. And last night I got that was me getting the return right there tenfold.